Hi friends, I have started a new YouTube channel. In this channel, I will show you the various telecom tool installation and tool demos as well. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and like my videos so that you can get the updates of all telecom tools. I will welcome to get your feedback and suggestions as well. And I will try to fulfill your queries as well. So let's start the demo with the Nemo GLS server installation. So let me start the demo. First of all, you have to search the services page. Open. Before GLS installation, you have to stop the services of Sentinel. This one, Sentinel LDK License Manager. As you can see over the screen, click on stop. Yes. So now Sentinel LDK manager is stopped. Minimize this screen. Now you can just open your Nemo server details, go to the download. In the download folder package, you can see there is a three packages there. So you have to use that user installation package for the GLS. Just click on this one and download the same. So this is approx 17.1 MB. So it will take few minutes for downloading. After this download, you have to copy this installation page in your Nemo Tools folder. Nemo Tools folder will be available in your C drive, and you can just copy this installation file in your C drive Nemo Tools folder. I will show you how. Please wait till download. So now downloading done. Let's click on the show in folder, Control X, go to C drive, Nemo Tools, and you can paste here, Control V. Now you can extract this package. If you can see that HSB file is there in your Nemo Tools folder. Just copy this Nemo Tools address bar, Control C. Now, next step is you have to install this HASP file in your system. So just go to the search bar and open command prompt, cmd, right click, run as administrator. So there is a command to install this file. So now cd space control v c colon backslash nemo space tools and press enter. So now you are already there. If you can see in the command prompt, you are on the Nemo Tools folder. So now you can type that haspdinst.exe space minus purge and enter. So it will take for a minute for installation of this older Sentinel driver. Click on OK. After that, you have to run the same file, same command file, but instead of purge, you have to press I stand for the installation. Click on enter. will take for a minute. Now it's done. Just click on OK. Close this command prompt. Close this folder. Now you have to again open the services page and click on the start Sentinel LDK manager. Click on start. For the safer side, you have to just run the restart as well. Click on restart. Now Sentinel LDK manager is running fine. There is no any issue with Sentinel LDK manager. Just cross this window. Now need to configure the GLS server. So just open this local server. I will show you the what is the local server ID of this. So this is the server ID, local server host ID. This local host means that is a whatever installation file you have installed earlier. So this is the folder for the Sentinel page running. Okay, so just type this address in your browser. Enter. Now it's open. So here one thing is there. Whenever you are going to install that Nemo GLS server, so I would suggest you just use the Google Chrome only. Please do not use Nemo, Mozilla, Firefox or Internet Explorer. Always use the Nemo for the Nemo server. Is a Google Chrome only. So you can see on the Sentinel keys, there is no any keys. The table is empty. Now I'm going to configure this server in Sentinel. Click on configuration, go to the network. So now you have to paste these files in your system. In network, EMS URL window. You can see there is a one server name, but it's a HTTP and HTTPS. So you have to use these two on the for the same IP address. And you have to use this GLS Nemo FI as well. Click on submit. Now close. So this is the admin page. I am going to add the subscriber for the user. So now you can just go to the add user. Just wait for a minute. Just a minute, I will show you how to add that account. I am on the admin page. Just click on add user, type your name. username, so in the username no need to use the capital letter in your username, but you can use that special character like underscore, at the rate, percentage, hash, star. Now I am going to choose that password. So just type your password, your own password, type your confirm password, same password as in password, and type your email ID, click on save. And then so whatever email ID you are mentioning here, you will get the user ID details on your email. So now I have already added the user. So I am just going to on the name of Cyrus. So just going to log off this admin page. Click on login. So this is my user page, whatever created. So I had created earlier. Now click on this get license. Choose your product. So I am going to choose the Nemo Outdoor. Here one more thing is there. I will suggest you can just use the before fetch the license. Please use the for the next day date, not the for 1 month, for 1 week. First whenever you are using first time, just use for 1 day date only. Okay, and click on get license. So one page will pop up. It's a license successfully acquired and installed. Click on OK. As you can see, there is a key host ID is there. Recipient ID. Recipient ID stands for the laptop name. Whatever name you have put it in your laptop. So this is the name of your recipient name. This is the laptop name. And here is the product. You can see Nemo Outdoor, product ID, license start date and time, and license end date and time. So this I have fetched this license on the 20th April 4:37, and now you can see the same will expire on after the 24 hours, that is 21 April 4:37. And you can see in the last that action is there, return and extend. So I will show you what is the use of this return and extend. So first we will check that license successfully fetched or not. So let me try to open Nemo Outdoor. Before that, I will show you. You can see in Sentinel page, now Sentinel key space is already added one license. You can see there is a configuration. If you can see in the session feature, you can see the expiration is a 21st April. Now we'll try to open that Nemo Outdoor. Now on cross, as you can see that Nemo Outdoor is working fine. It's opening well. There is no any error and no any issues. Now I will show you how to check the license. Click on question mark below the cross, license information. So one page will pop up. This is license information. As you can see, there is a serial number, expiration date, technical support expiration, country uses. Country means country code. There is 404, 405, 406. Network is unlimited, and you can see that outdoor voice and data is a some cap is there. So outdoor voice 9 means you can use, and there is outdoor data as well as 9. So you can use the combination of 9 device only, either either voice, 9 device of voice, or either 9 device of data. As you can do the combination as well, like 6 device for voice and 3 device for data. So you can use like as combination like this. As you can see, there is no any streaming quality, no any voice MOS, Payscan, Polka, and there is no any PVQS services, video quality services. As you can see, the license things are there. If you want to send this or save this license in your system, just click on copy. No need to do the snipping tool, no need to use the snipping tool, just click on copy, close, minimize this outdoor, and try to open Excel file. In the Excel, just type Control V, and as you can see, the same licenses, whatever license we have checked here in the pop-up, you can see same license details are there in your Excel file. So you can save this file for your future purpose, or if somebody want what are the licenses are there in your GLS server, you can use this Excel, or you can forward this Excel to them. So I don't have any need this Excel, so I will click on don't save, close this. So currently there is no any handset or devices added in my laptop. So let me try to add the offline device for you. Just click, choose the handler, click on next. If device is added, there is a trace port and there is a modem port will be there. And always use the NEMO outdoor in automatic mode. If any devices are connected with the laptop, so that port you can get it here. And you can add with the voice quality and video quality as well, like NEMO outdoor, NEMO media router, and PESC, and choose the voice quality PESC or Polka, or choose the video quality as well, PVQS. Just click OK. As you can see, there is no any error with the offline device as well, and we can see and we can use this device. So there is no any issue with the licenses. Just I am going to cross this outdoor, click on no. Now, so this license is working fine. I will tell you what is the use of this return and extend. So as you can see, if you want, this license is valid till 21st of April 4:37 p.m. So now if I want this license till for 1 week, so just click on extend, choose the date till 1 week, and click on extend. You will get one pop-up, license successfully extended. Click on OK. So as you can see, that license is extended. The license in time will be 29th of April 2020, 4:37 p.m. Now, if you can see, if you will face the why I'm telling you that recipient or laptop name should be unique. If you can use the same laptop name in 4 laptop and you have the 4 license, and you already fetched the license in all 4 laptop, that fetching is not the problem. But if you are going to return the license or extend the license, so that system will, that NEMO GLS server will not, will get the issue. So which laptop license need to extend or return? So this is the main issue. That's why I'm telling you. So just please use the unique laptop name or system name while using the NEMO GLS server. So let me return this license. If you can see in the GLS page, just click on refresh. check the session. As you can see, I've extended the two with the two session. That's why that there is two session is there. Click on features. You can see the expiration date. Expiration date is 29th of April. Okay. Now click on Sentinel page. Go to here. I am just going to return this license. Click on OK. So same page will pop up. License returned successfully. Click on OK. So now this license page is blank. As you can see, just click on refresh. You can see that now table is also empty. So whatever license we are fetching from the NemoGLS server, so there is a file. There is a file. It will be created in your C drive Anite folder. I will show you where. There is a two types of folder are there. Go to the program files. Click on common folder. Click on Anite. Hold on. Program 86 file, Aladdin shares. Click on HSP file. If you can see, there is a multiple files are there, but whenever we are going to fetch the license, you can see in the cancel folder or and you can see that licenses, we have already written the license. That's why that there is no any H2R file. So you can see, as you can see, we have already written the license. So you can see that R2H file is there. So sometime it will happen. This license return issue will be there. Now let me grab the license again. Click on OK. As you can see in the folder, program 86, common files, Aladdin shared, HSP file. As you can see, this is the H2R file. So just click on this one. So license already downloaded. Sometime this table will be empty. So what you have to do, and there and you will get that, you will get the Nemo order will not be open, you will get the error. So some after that, if this table is empty, so just go to just download this H2R file from here, from the license page, active license page, and go to the Sentinel, click on update, choose the file, and just choose the file, this H2R file, this one, click and open and apply the file. After that, you can see this page will be the same, that local 9548 key host ID and HSP file HL mode. This, there is a certificate for the configuration and version and session and all the things are there. After that, you can just open the Nemo Outdoor. Your outdoor will open there. You will not get any error in that outdoor. So same thing, sometime license is not going to return. So you have to do the same process. How? Just go to the Sentinel page, click on update. And now you have to open the same cancel file. This one. 446, just now we have grabbed this license. Just open this one, copy this address bar, choose the file from here, just paste and choose the at the time of fetching cancellation file or fetching time. So you can see that 4:46 p.m. was there. So just select this file and click on open and apply the file. So you can see that license will be returned from the Sentinel page, and just click on refresh as well from here. So as you can see, there is this pale active license page will be also empty. Now I am going to return this license. License returned successfully. Log out. Crossed. So as you can see that this is the demo of Nemo GLS server. So this is it. So please use this video for your next installation of GLS file. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and my videos, so you can get the update all telecom tools. I will welcome to get your feedback and suggestion as well. I will try to fulfill your queries as well. So let's close this demo for the time. Please do like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel Telecom Funda, and share your feedback in your comment section. Thank you so much guys. Thanks.